here. This is Jaqueline's Inside Out, and we are all about beauty, fashion, wellness, and inspiration. So I wanted to share a few things with you today to help you feel a little bit better. I wanted to give you some tips for some new habits that you might like that you can start to do and implement into your daily routine to help you feel better and to give you some encouragement. So I wanna start with uplifting and opening your eyes and helping them to feel, you know, brighter and more awake. So I always say under here, I get a lot of dark circles. I just naturally do. It just happens in through here. So I have to work on that a little bit. So right here is a very sensitive area, right? Underneath our eyes is a very sensitive area. So you wanna be gentle with that area and you wanna use some products in a gentle way. So what I like to do is take a little bit of my concealer and just dab that on lightly. And then I like to just take my ring finger and just lightly go in and pat that in underneath. Now you don't want to go too far up to your eye. You want to keep it down a little bit where the darkness starts to happen and where that starts to blend out here is what you want to just tap into. Okay, so I'm just kind of tapping lightly there with my ring finger and just forming a little bit of a soft motion to help keep that gentle area, to help in that gentle area with a light movement. So I'm not putting too much pressure there, okay? So doing that and using a concealer right under there is gonna help to brighten that area and make your eyes feel more awake. If you have dark circles, I do recommend a peach tone to your concealer because that's gonna neutralize that darkness a little bit, okay? All right, so that's tip number one. Tip number two today is to do some brows lifting. A lift in your brows is gonna help you to uplift your eyes. It's gonna make them appear wider and open and more awake. So you can use a brow brush or a brow tint, you can use pencil, you can use shadows. There's different things that you can use. I'm gonna use a little bit of a gel and I'm just getting it off of my little palette here. It's like a gel base and I'm actually using a liner brush because I like to have the way that it points on here to lift and shape the brow. So what you wanna do is just feather lightly up in an upward motion. Everything up so that you are lifting. Everything's going in upward motion to lift. So you want to start in an upward motion here and get to your middle where you want to start your arch and then it starts to fall back down. So you want to lift and brush up and get to your arch and then come back down lightly. And you want the corner to be a lighter consistency down here. Okay, now a trick for this is whenever you're doing your brows, you wanna measure. So you don't wanna go past the corner of your nose up here, you measure, and you don't wanna go past there with any product in here, okay? Same thing this way, you wanna measure the outer corner. This is your inner corner and your outer corner, and you don't wanna go past your outer corner with that as well. So keep that in mind when you are putting the placement of, you know, where the line will be, where it'll start and end, okay? So those are just some tricks to do there. Now what you can do is if you have any overflow or you have any unevenness, you can take again your brush with your concealer and just go over top and just blend that out lightly right there around your line to help to form that a little bit better, okay? So that's gonna lift, it's gonna lift your eye, it's gonna lift your brow, and it's just gonna give you a brighter look because you got this under here, and then you got your brows coming up a little bit with that feathered look. So you wanna feather it up. That gives it a nice natural look to it. Okay, so those are some tricks for an instant eye lift to help, you know, glamorize your eyes a little bit, open them up, and lift them. The older we get, we start to, you know, our gravity is just pulling us down. So you want to start lifting that up, and you want to start doing some little tricks to help, you know, give you that little vibrant look and that lifted look. So an instant natural, which I love the natural look to things. I'm more of that natural kind of feel. You know, I just like that a lot better. So you can do that just slightly with a little bit of product. It doesn't have to be over the top, just to give you that lift. Okay, so try that little trick. It's a little new habit that you can do to help, you know, get some glow back and just transform you into a nice, healthier, glowy look in your eyes. Okay, so I wanted to share that with you. My next little thing today is I wanted to show you how you can take some spray quick tan. This is a bronzer, like a spray tan, that you can just do for something fun. It's summertime, we wanna glisten a little more. We're, you know, maybe we are trying to do some things. Maybe we're going to the lake if you can, or the beach if you can. I know we're under all these restrictions and things like that. Or even just going out on a little date. We can go into restaurants, you know, somewhat. Or if you're just sitting at home and you just feel like you wanna be brighter and you wanna have a little glow to you, because you're feeling that you really need that because we're used to that, this is a nice way to get it. So you have to be very careful when you're spraying. You don't want to overspray because this can kind of get on things and it can get on your clothes. It can get around you because it's a spray. So you have to be very careful with that. I do have a towel down, so I recommend that you do that, or just do it in a room where you don't, you're not worried, or you know that you can just clean it up easily. So just be careful with your clothes and everything. You want to shake it up really good to get the consistency of the product evenly, especially if it's been sitting. And then you want to stay a little bit away, and you just want to lightly just spray right over top, and you can see it's starting to glisten already. And then you just, very simple, just rub that in, and it's just going to give you a nice little soft glisten to your skin, and it's just going to be really pretty for this time of year. So you don't have to go, you know, out if you can't get out in the sun right now. We're not doing all the trips. Maybe you are, maybe you're not, but this is just a nice little way to add and enhance some color to your skin. I know it makes you feel better whenever you have some color. You know, when we do have color on us, it makes us feel a little bit better. So I would recommend that. Make sure you're using a good product that's not harmful to your skin or your body, or you know, anything like that. So make sure you're using a good product that will, you know, be natural for you and help you to, you know, keep your skin in good shape. Okay, all right, so with that, that was fun. I think, you know, getting some glisten and getting some glow to your skin is going to really make you feel better. It's going to help brighten up your day. So it's all about glowing today, right? Glowing under the eyes, lifting our eyes, getting our skin glowing, which is really nice. So you want to do that. Now I'm going to use a little bit of a humidifier blow, a blowout humidifier treatment on top, which is really nice. It helps with humidity because we want our hair to glisten. So you want to just spray a little bit of shine or a little bit of glow on your hair to help, you know, have some glisten to your hair as well. It's all about today just having some glow to our skin and our hair and everything. So I just want to, and you know, encourage you to get glowing again, get moving, get up, and just, you know, get, feel brighter and feel better, right? Because it's been a rough few months, but we're getting through it, and we're just gonna, you know, shine up a little bit. You can also take a little bit of a shine gloss for your lips. I already have a color on as my base here, a nice summer pink, and then I'm just gonna take a little bit of my glisten on top. And when you wanna do something like just glowing up your lips, you can put a little dab right there in the middle, and that's really all you need. And then just pucker them together and let your lips kind of move together, and you get like a nice soft glisten to them. So this is a nice glow soft pink look that I just put over top of my darker pink, and it just brightens it up and gives it a nice glowy look. Again, we're talking about glowiness, and we're talking about just new habits and how to feel better and brighter today. So I think that's a fun little trick for you. Okay, so that was all of the beauty tips for you that I want you to kind of start new habits. And I would love to hear what you're doing and how you're using some of these tricks to do that. Now, I do have a little extra surprise too with a hat. I want to show you how this fun hat can just brighten up your day as well. You know, any hats, any accessories are just always fun. So you want to use, you know, some little fun accessories. This has a really cute tassel on it, which is really nice. It's a cowgirl, cowboy hat, I feel, but it's a little bit floppy. It has like a lot of movement to it. It's really fun. So with that said, you can go ahead and use hats in different ways. So I like, I love hats. I do love hats. I love to wear them as best as I can. Certain hats I like to wear, and I have fun with these kinds. So if you go ahead and just put them on and then pull it down a little bit, you want to show your eyes and you want to bring out your eyes and enhance your eyes more. So I would recommend taking it right to the tip of your brows. You know, you lifted them and you got your eyes enhanced and you got your eyes bright, and you want to show them off. So don't cover them too much. Lift them up and let, you know, show through the hat so you can see your eyes really good. So this is one way that you can do the hat, right? You can do it like this and just wear it like this with your hair down, and it's cute and it kind of gives you, you know, it's a fun little look, you know, something different. But if you wanted to change it up, you could split your hair into two. You could do two little ponytails like on each side if you wanted to make it fun like that. You could pull this around and bring it all over here on the side and do like a little pin up like that and have like a soft little, you know, side pony to it. You could do something like that. You could pull it all over real tight and do like a little chignon with it as well, if you wanted to do something like that. So that's cute too. There's just so many things, so many options that you can do with a hat. And I think that you should, you know, try some different things and try some fun little things. I like to just wear it down and kind of have the curls coming around. It would look really cute, sleek too. So if you wanted to do like a sleek look and pull this out straight, that would look really cute too. So try something fun, try something different with your hats and, you know, just with everything that's going on. I think it's gonna make you feel better. It's gonna, you know, just give you something to look forward to. Even if you're just going to a picnic in the yard with your family, you know, just do something fun. Get yourself a little beach hat. Sit at your pool if you have a blow-up pool or a regular pool, or if your community pool's open, if you're not heading to a lake or a beach and you can't do that, you know, why not pretend that we are sitting on the beach, right? And just having a good time enjoying life. That's what we need to do. So I want you to be encouraged to try something different. You know, just curl your hair, smooth it back. It just is a fun little look. So I want you to be encouraged to do that. My last little tip for you today is, of course, my inspirational tip that I love to give you. So this is a Jesus is Calling book. It's a daily devotional of different days. Every day there's a new date, you know, it goes with the dates of the day, and every day there's a new little devotional that is on there, and then there's a, you know, Bible verse at the bottom, which is amazing. And I want to encourage you to maybe start to do something different with your routine, to get up in the morning and take a little time for yourself to write down in a journal your gratitude for the day, or read a devotional like this, you know, a daily devotional. Maybe just take some notes on how you're feeling. Get in touch with your mind and just get in touch with how you've been feeling. We've all been going through so much, and I have really been changing my habits in the morning with that. I've been doing that a lot all through this whole quarantine. I've always done stuff like that, but I've really tuned into it through the quarantine, where I'm trying to focus in on the morning and, you know, just doing some different things in the morning to start my day off better. So I think if we all just start to do that, change our habits, have a transformation, take action, like do all these things that, you know, we wish that we would do, start doing them and start putting them into place. And I feel that you're just going to have such a better day. And you know, you're going to make a massive step to progress, whatever that is you're trying to do, whether you're just trying to be better with your family, or you're, you know, trying to be a better mom, you're trying to be a better daughter, you know, a better friend, or just whatever it is, maybe your business, you're trying to do things different in your business, or you're just trying to just, you know, be a good wife, whatever it is that you're doing. If we take these little steps and start our day off good and right, I think that you're going to have set you up for success. You're going to have a better day. You're going to get results. I want to invite you to just join in with me. I'm working on a lot of things here. I'm getting a lot of things going, and I'm trying to bring you a lot of good positive energy. You know, I'm putting together some different things. We're gonna have a program, a mastermind, classes, everything like that with beauty, fashion, wellness, and inspiration. I'm so excited to share it with you coming up. So I'm sitting here with this hat on just to kind of show you some fun things that you can do to help you feel better. I hope that you enjoyed this and you got some, you know, nice tips to help you glow a little bit more this summer. The summer's still here. That's enjoy it, that's glow. That's just be positive, be a positive force and a positive energy, and help everybody to just feel better. So, you know, I'm here for you. And if you need anything, please reach out to me. I would love your feedback. Please leave comments how I can help you. My team and I are here for you. Our concierge, we're here to help you to, you know, just get on the right track. And we're so excited about the future and what it holds. 2020 does not have to be a bad year. That's try to make it something positive out of this whole thing. It's been hard for so many people, and so many people have different things that are happening with it, whether you're losing a business or you've lost a loved one, which I'm so sorry. And that's just something that's just hard to wrap our heads around, right? But we have, you know, in light of all that, that's just be a positive force for good. And that's make a positive change for something out of it, to make it good for everybody. And hopefully what I'm doing here is something that's going to help bring you some joy or some positivity. Okay, well, I'm going to go. But thank you so much for tuning in. And I hope you like the little hat. And I hope you like all the tips for, you know, remember to do your little look underneath with your eyes and brighten and lift your eyes and your little bit of glow on your lips, and of course our tanning glow, and get out there and glow a little bit more this rest of this summer. We have time. Okay, have a great rest of your day. Thank you so much for joining in, and you all take care. I'll see you soon.